Hi everyone, this is the another problem on method of variation of parameters. See the statement. Solve d square y by dx square plus 3 into dy by dx plus 2y is equal to e power x. Okay, clearly by seeing the right hand side function structure, we can conclude that we cannot solve this problem by using general trick, which is 1 by f of d into q of x, which is used to find yp. Okay, we can't use that formula. So here we are going to apply method of variation of parameters. Okay, see, first of all write the operator form. Okay, so the operator form of given differential equation is, what is it? d square by dx square is nothing but capital D square plus 3 times of d by dx is nothing but 3d plus 2 of y is equal to e power x. Take it equation number 1. Okay, now here you should write what is the function of d in the given problem. D square plus 3d plus 2, and d is nothing but d by dx. Okay, and what is capital R? Right hand side function. Okay, e power x. So what is the auxiliary equation? The form of our auxiliary equation is f of m is equal to 0. Okay, so it would be m square plus 3m plus 2 is equal to 0. So 1 into 2 are the multipliers. So 1 plus 2 is 3. That's why I will write the directly factors m plus 1 into m plus 2 is equal to 0. Okay, so from this, what are the factors? What are the roots? Minus 1, minus 2. Real and different. That's why the complementary function of 1 is yc is equal to c1 e power minus x plus c2 e power minus 2x. Okay, so here what is u value in the method of variation of parameters? The coefficient of c1, the coefficient of the first parameter is u, and what is v? This one, e power minus 2x. So by the method of variation of parameters, let us take Pi as yp is equal to, in this method always we can choose yp from yc only. Okay, so what is yc? C1 into power minus x plus c2 into power minus 2x. Here replace c1 by capital A, into e power minus x plus replace c2 by b into e power minus 2x. And here a, b are not parameters. A is a function of x and b is also a function of x. Okay, before finding that values, you should get Wronskian of uv. Wronskian of uv is nothing but uv, u dash v dash, which is the second rule. Uv dash minus u dash uv, uv dash minus u dash v. Okay, what is u? E power minus x. What is v dash? Derivative of e power minus 2x, it would be minus 2 into e power minus 2x. Minus, now derivative for the first term, which is minus, minus of minus plus, e power minus x into v is the similar term, e power minus 2x. So this can be written as minus 2 into e power minus 3x. Since bases are equal, you can add the powers. Plus, here also bases are equal, so you can add the powers. Minus x minus 2x would be minus 3x. So it is nothing but minus e power minus 3x. This is the Wronskian of uv. Wronskian of u comma v. Okay, now we can easily get the values of a and b. See, now a is equal to minus integral vr by uv dash minus u dash v, otherwise simply you can write cron skin of UV into dx. See, so replace the values, minus integral, what is v, e power minus 2x into what is r, right hand side function, which is e power x by what is the Wronskian, e power minus 3x into dx. Okay, so that is equal to minus minus getting cancelled. Here shift the denominator to numerator, so you will get e power minus 2x into e power. If we shift this denominator to numerator, this power becomes positive, so bases are equal, minus 2x plus 3x, it would be e power x. So minus minus getting cancelled, so you get positive e power x into e power x into dx. Now how can we find out the integration here? By replace e power x is equal to t, put e power x is equal to t, the next integration becomes to e power x into dx. Take the derivative on both sides, you will get e power x dx is equal to dt. So this integration becomes e power x dx, nothing but dt, e power t into dt. So what is the integration of e power t? E power t only. So e power t, that is equal to what is t? E power x. This is the value of a, e power x. Okay, now we have to find out the value of b. What is the formula for b? B is equal to integral u r by Wronskian of uv into dx, that is equal to what is u? E power minus x into what is r? e power x by Wronskian is minus e power minus 3x into dx. So this can be written as minus into, take this denominator to numerator, so you will get e power minus x into e power 3x. Okay, bases are equal, you can add the powers, you will get 3x minus x e power 2x into e power x. See the simplification. This integral can be written as minus e power 2x can be written as e power x, and I will write this one e power x into, write another e power x here. Okay, e power x into e power x is nothing but e power 2x. Now again use the same substitution method, you will get e power x is equal to t, so e power x into dx is equal to dt. So I will write e power x into dx as dt, and whenever we have e power x, replace it by t, so minus into t into e power t into dt. So it is a direct formula, minus e power t into t minus 1, so replace t is equal to e power x. By using UV rule you can easily get this one. Okay, minus e power x into what is t? e power x minus 1. In this way we can crack the value of b. Okay, after getting the value of b, replace the values of a and b in equation number 2. Okay, substitute a comma b in equation number 2, so you will get yp. What is yp? A into e power minus x, so e power minus x into e power x plus b value into e power minus 2x. So this is already negative sign, so positive into negative would be negative, write this term e power x into e power x minus 1. In the product of b, you have e power minus 2x. Okay, so e power minus x into e power x minus e power x into e power x minus into minus plus. Of course here we have e power minus 2x also, e power minus 2x into e power x would be e power minus x. Okay, so minus into minus plus e power minus 2x into e power x. Okay, so we are observing that these both terms getting cancelled, so simply you will get yp is equal to e power minus 2x into e power x. So don't forget to write the general solution, it is student part. general solution of 1 is y is equal to yc plus yp. Okay. In this way, we can complete the problem. In the next video, I will give some more problems on solving higher order linear differential equations with constant coefficients. Thank you very much.